科学家认为气候变化是极端天气事件数量增加的原因。美国宇航局高级气候顾问加文·施密特说，问题是从温度上升开始的。
As the planet warms, the ocean absorbs that heat, and that's causing the ocean to expand. So that fills the basins more and more. But of course, as we're warming, we're also melting ice. We're melting ice in mountain areas. Glaciers are retreating. All of that water is effectively ending up in the ocean.
施密特说，地球的温度升高使得土地变干，进而导致野火发生，就像墨西哥的这一个。埃德加·戈多伊是雨林联盟的墨西哥督导，这个非营利组织致力于保护农民和大自然。他说，大火、洪水和冰川融化已成为常态。
And every year in Mexico, as I think in the whole world, we are always saying, oh, this was the hottest year in the last 5 years, but it's happening year after year after year. So this is something that is not changing, no?
墨西哥城2000万居民当中，三分之一受到缺水的影响。戈多伊说，在几乎持续的干旱威胁下，农民无法只仰赖他们的庄稼过活。
As they don't have like the income that they were expecting from a specific crop, maybe they will need to go to the forest or the rainforest and clear cut it.To sell some wood or some other things that are having impact on deforestation or degradation of forest and rainforest.
随着树木因全面滥砍而消失，它们的根部无法再保持水土，山体滑坡和洪水因而增加。雨林联盟在印度尼西亚的工作人员英坦·法迪纳特里说。这些自然灾害对那些依靠土地为生的人打击最为严重。
The agriculture rural community, is always like they are in a very remote area, and by having landslide, you know, damaging the infrastructure, so they are even remote than before, isolated.
法迪纳特里说。不稳定的气候模式导致印度尼西亚的咖啡产量减半，该国的可可和咖啡种植者已看到自己的生计萎缩。
When they were young, it wasn't like this, and now, the soil getting exhausted, soil is dry.
他说，经济发展和保护环境之间的冲突。可能会使那些本来理所当然的农作物越来越难持续种植。美国之音记者阿拉巴萨迪报道。